My name is Ofem Ukit.
Ofem Ukit.
Ukit. Yes.
You are.
I'm the special assistant to the Minister of Media and Communication Strategy.
Which minister, please?
Minister of State for Power.
Assistant.
The name of the minister, please.
Jedi Agba. God Jedi Agba.
God Jedi Agba.
God is JD Agba.
Put on that microphone, please. Or you can just be on the
ground. Yes.
Yeah. Like, allegation was made about your minister or your principal a while ago that he was detaining a journalist, 72 years old journalist.
Yeah.
What can you say about that?
Yeah, that's not true. We have issued a statement, and some national dailies have carried those statements, like Daily Trust and some of these national dailies, especially the Power correspondents whom we spoke to. And when initially the statement was issued or was about to be issued, they were reluctant. But when they saw the enormity of the grievous allegations that were made by the publisher of Power Steering magazine, they had no choice but to carry the stories. If you check today's dailies, you see the statement that was issued. I signed that statement. Let me tell you one thing. We are all major actors in this industry. I have done 20-something years in the media, and I don't think that the mainstream media will come out with such an outrageous, you know, allegations and publications that an individual paid to crash an airline belonging to Dana. Dana has a reputation to uphold. Dana has an integrity to uphold. Dana has been operating in the airspace of this country for a very long time. And I don't see any reason why they will jettison their integrity by accepting to take money from anybody to crash an airline that has won over 190 passengers that were flying from Abuja to Lagos. That is terrorism. Let me tell you something. What this man has done, he has linked the minister to an act of terrorism without him knowing. We have to streamline this industry. We have to make sure that this industry is put on the right path. We cannot go about blackmailing people. We cannot go about intimidating people because we are journalists. In that aircraft that we talk about, the Accident Investigation Bureau, AIB, which comprises of experts from the manufacturers of the aircraft, experts from the aviation industry, experts from the NNPC, experts from relevant institutions comprises or were composed in that committee, the AIB. And the report came out. And as at the time the report came out, JD Agba was not indicted, was not mentioned as a mastermind or an orchestrator of that crash. And of course, the report says the airline which was flown from Calabar to Abuja and now had to take passengers from Abuja to Lagos has a dual failure of its engines. That means one of the engine or two of the engines have failed. And let me also remind you that the same pilot was to fly to the United States of America that same evening. And so he was going to Lagos to ensure that he meets up with his flight to the United States. He was even on holidays. Let me tell you one thing. When the dual engine of that aircraft failed, all that the pilot needed to have done is to locate the available airport or airstrip where he could land, but he didn't do so. And the report came out clearly to say that. But for you to single out an individual because he works at the NNPC as at that time, and some of the NNPC staff were on board of that aircraft, and you now allege that he crashed the aircraft because he want to hide some corrupt practices around him, that is grievous. Do you understand? It is grievous, and there is no single individual anywhere in the world who compromise on that. And so JD Agba is not holding Tom Ohia. What JD Agba has done was to complain to the police that, listen, this man has linked me with terrorism. And the people, the police authority has to go into the publication and discover that the man has alleged that the police bribed J.D. Agba. I mean, yes, bribed, the J.D. Agba bribed the police. The J.D. Agba bribed the SSS so that they can suppress the investigation into that matter. Why is it that the AIB report did not mention all these things? He was the only person. And as at the time the report came out, why didn't he contest the report? Relevant authorities in this country did not contest the report. And today, 8 years down the lane, he had come out with enough of blackmail. This profession must be sanitized. And let me tell you, I have said it before, Daily Trust cannot carry that kind of story. Leadership cannot carry it. This day cannot, AIT cannot carry such stories. It is only somebody who prints at Area 3 or Area 10 who had to gather things together. He is the editor. If you say, I have reported, I covered, I'm a political correspondent. I covered the National Assembly for a very long time. I was acting bureau chief for National Mirror. I worked in leadership newspaper. I have been an actor in this industry. And I know that when you send a report, it goes through a line editors. And at a point, the editors will tell you, no, we cannot go into this. And they will step down that story. Because it's a one-man business, he can go anywhere and pack documents and begin to blackmail people. That is not right. We have to stop that.
The detention.
Let me tell you something. The man will be taken to court, and of course, the police. You saw Frank Mba issued a statement that the police has secured a warrant of arrest. Remember, this man was being trailed since July. He has had several invitations from the police authorities, and he has been hiding. He was running away, and until October when the police caught him. Do you understand? He has been on the trail of the police since July this year, but he has been running away. But they got him in October. Several invitations to him to appear lawfully, to put the facts straight, you know, prove the abortive. And so they went into investigation until they caught him. Oh, come, explain to us. Give us documents that shows that we paid money to, I mean, J.D. Agba paid us money to suppress investigation into this matter. Also provide us documents to show when J.D. Agba gave money to Dana authorities to crash these airlines. He has no documents to prove all these allegations. Wild allegations for that matter. Wild allegations. It is enough for this profession to weed this profession of facts.
Why is it not charged to court?
Like I said, he will be charged to court. No. That is left for the police. The police is handling this. Okay. Like I said, J.D. Agba has no link with the arrest of the man. And being detained because he is just a complainant. He complained. He's a complainant. That is what I've told you. He has complained to, like every other person, he has the right to complain to the police that, listen to me, somebody has maligned me. Somebody has written this thing. Somebody has linked me with terrorism. And that, look, it is not proper. And the police invited him. Like I said before, the police kept inviting him severally from July. He never showed up. And so, if the police eventually get him and say, look, you have to appear in court, how does that concern the Minister of State for Power?
So are you saying that your principal has no hand in
it? He does not have any hand in his detention. That is what I'm telling you.
What is he going to be charged with? Where?
I don't know. I am not the police. The police authorities will answer that. I don't know about that. The police authorities. It is not petition. I am saying that it's a complainant. I don't know what they are talking about. He is a complainant anywhere in the world. I don't understand. I said the man who has alleged that the police has taken bribe to suppress investigation. The police has its own matter that is taking this man to court. Do you understand? It is a police matter. It is between him and the police authority. It is not between him and J.D. Agba. That's what I want you guys to know.
Are you aware that the task of investigating terrorism is not lying with the police? in life in the DSS.
I don't know about that. I don't know about that. I am saying that this matter, you cannot tell me I collected bribe from somebody, so, and that is, so, look, so it is.
If you are alleging that he lied against the minister and he led him to act of terrorism,
yes.
Why is not the DSS, that is handling it? Where is it?
I don't know about that. I have told you what I want to tell you. The what?
Your minister visited the top of Uya.
I'm not aware of that. He has not told me.
And you have had a link between the Inspector General Police and the minister.
That is sentiments. I'm not aware of that.
Yeah,
we are not, I am not here for sentiments. Listen to me. Listen to me. Listen to me.
Get it right. Let me inform you.
Yes.
The DIG was missing.
Yes.
The immediate younger brother to the mother.
I am not here to speak to sentiments. Brother, sister, community, that is not why I'm here. I am here to tell you that it is enough for us in the media. Look, we are responsible citizens of this country. Nobody should use you. Do you understand? Nobody should use you. We are responsible people in this country. And so, anybody anywhere that comes to begin to see to the fact that he wants to ridicule this establishment or this industry called the media, my brother, you cannot do that. I am a mainstream person in this instance. I challenge anybody who has been in the mainstream to tell me that you are telling lies. I am in the mainstream. So you can't come from nowhere to begin to harass and intimidate people unlawfully. That cannot be. It's unacceptable.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes. I am in the mainstream. Challenge me that I am in the mainstream.
Sir, thank you so much. Please.
Yeah. Mr. Ofem Ukit, that's my name.
Okay, that's a question.
Yes, yes.
I have a question for you, sir.
Go ahead.
When the council chairman and
yes.
the secretary met with the minister,
yeah, sure.
initially he has given them his word
yeah.
that maybe power steering was going to be released.
Okay.
Just that same day, in
yes.
the evening,
mm.
because he saw the report of Sahara Reporter,
mm.
and he said, oh, so maybe you people did not have it in mind to forego this thing. So don't you think something is fishy?
The minister,
see at the initial stage, he agreed that was going to, now you are saying with the police that is holding.
The minister is not empowered by the provisions of the law to arrest, detain or release anybody in this country. He's a minister, that is not electricity.
Okay, sir.
The police only and security agencies are empowered by the provisions of the law to do that.
So let me quote you, sir. Are you not saying the police and law enforcement agents in Nigeria are empowered by the constitution to arrest and detain a journalist in more than 3 weeks?
I don't know about that.
No, let me quote you, sir.
I don't know about that. You cannot quote me. I don't know about that.
You're correct to say that you don't even know anything about this issue.